Hey, after watching this video, check out the new PhoneDog.com homepage and play the One Pod Bandit for your chance to win free phones.
We'll look at the media players now on both. The iPhone, obviously, you know, it's got the whole Apple iPod ecosystem and everything. The Pre, a little bit more, you know, kind of a basic media player. They both work well. They both sound good. They're both, you know, kind of visually appealing. As I'm doing this, you can, you know, get a sense of what the screens look like on the different devices. I'll tell you off the top, I'm really just impressed with the way everything looks on the Pre. And I'll get into that a little bit more when we talk about the actual web OS. But, you know, just very colorful, very easy on the eyes and everything. Not that the iPhone's not, but I guess the iPhone's been around now for a few years, and so we're kind of used to what it looks like. I'm kind of used to what it looks like. And, you know, the Pre, it's a new look, and they did a great job with it. So you can see when you look at artists, the Pre gives you kind of album cover looks and tells you how many tracks are in each artist thing. The iPhone, a little more of a kind of bare bones look. When you get into the actual, let's see if I've got the same exact track on both devices. We'll go to TV on the Radio, Dear Science. Yeah, so we'll go to Halfway Home on both. So you can get a look at exactly what it looks like. So a couple things of note. In this album art cover mode, iPhone gives you the kind of progress bar scrubber so you can go through the track. Pre does not. iPhone gives you a touchscreen controlled volume control. So you can see I can. And this is new on the iPhone OS 3. When you click, you get, it says high speed, half speed or quarter speed scrubbing and that whole thing. So they kind of refine that a little bit. Pre doesn't give you anything like that. You can control the volume on the side of the phone. Not a big deal to do. You can also do that on the iPhone. But you don't get the on-screen look. Now, if you go into the list mode, so iPhone gives you the track listing, how long each track is, and you can click to play a different track, that whole thing. Pre gives you the similar thing, but this is where you get the progress bar. So you can see, you know, how far along in the track you are. Elapsed time remaining, stuff like that, and then you can press to hold to scrub through, that kind of thing. So just a little bit different. Both have shuffle controls. iPhone, I guess, doesn't have the shuffle control when you're in the list mode, but it does if you go back to album art mode. You get your shuffle controls and the whole Genius thing, which I'm not a big user of myself. But anyway, so there you go. So the, you know, the MP3 player, a little bit more sophisticated on the iPhone, but also it's just kind of a different look. But the scrubbing is a little bit more sophisticated, I think, on the iPhone than on the Pre. You can swipe things out of your playlist on the Pre, which is kind of fun. Hopefully I didn't just mess up my whole album track listing there, but whatever. I don't think I did. So we'll go back, we'll hit the now playing button and just get this to be quiet for a second. Also, there's no equalizer on the Pre, no tone controls. On the iPhone, you can do that from the settings. You can go to the settings for iPod and there's sound check, there's EQ, there's now shake to shuffle, volume limit, all that stuff. No EQ to be found on the Pre just yet. Again, hopefully they'll address that in an update soon. One thing that's kind of cool on the Pre is you can go to the music menu and you can go to YouTube and you can search for the artist name or the track name on YouTube. So I can hit search TV on the radio and it'll open up a new card, and that's how the Pre works with the OS, is the card system. Again, we'll get to that in a different video, and it launches the YouTube app, and then I can go and I can play a related clip. So that's kind of a cool little thing that it does. And there's your YouTube app. One of my favorite YouTube videos, actually. That's a great video. If you're a fan of TV on the radio. Anyway, so, and you can do the same thing also via the Amazon MP3 store, which is how you buy, you purchase and download songs directly to the Pre. So Paul Mintzmann using the Amazon MP3 store. Apple, of course, has their whole iTunes system. So we'll go to the iTunes store. We're not going to go into a whole long thing on this because, you know, lots of information out there on the iTunes store, obviously. But Amazon MP3, all DRM free. The price kind of varies depending on what you're looking at. Apple now has a similar model as well. Obviously, with the iTunes store, you can get videos, podcasts, all that stuff. It's just been around longer. The Amazon MP3 store, it works great. I bought and downloaded an album. You can check that out in one of the other videos. Works just fine. The store is not quite as marketing heavy, I guess you would say, as the Apple store is. Not as many categories, ways to search, you know, promos, that kind of stuff. But you still get your ratings. You can still go through and, you know, preview tracks, and you can buy tracks individually, or you can buy the whole album. With the, you know, Apple store, you can go through and you can read and write reviews. You can't do that on the Pre just yet. You can preview tracks. So and over here I can preview a track also. So there you go. So with the whole, you know, the whole MP3 player, again, a little bit of an advantage to the iPhone, but they both work, and we'll just kind of, it depends what you want. If you just want something that plays MP3s, you don't care about equalizers or buying music over the air or anything like that, you know, Pre's just fine and it sounds good. That's what matters most. But the iPhone offers a little bit more in the way of options, both in terms of playback and in terms of ways to get content onto the device wirelessly if you're willing to pay for it. Or, you know, you can go through and you can do the whole podcast thing via the iTunes store, which is kind of nice if you're into that kind of thing. In terms of multitasking, so listening to music while you're doing stuff on the device, they both do it. The Pre system is a little bit more sophisticated. I'll fire up a song here. And so I'll go back to the beginning. And on my iPhone, it's playing now. On the Pre, I can actually just, from down there in the little notifications bar, I can control what I'm doing, and then I can kind of swipe up, and I can go back to it so I can get rid of the store, and I can go back to what I'm doing. And this gets into the whole WebOS multitasking thing. But it's kind of nice to be able to just touch and advance a track, or pause, and I don't have to be, you know, I can be doing something else entirely while I'm doing this. I can be looking at my Twitter feed and then controlling my music from right down here, which is great. On the iPhone, you know, you can control your music in the background. I can be looking at, also look at my Twitter feed, and then you can program your home button to do different things. So mine's programmed to double tap will bring up the iPod, and I can control it from here as well, and then go to the iPod. So, you know, a little bit different implementation, but same basic principle. Pre, just a little slicker, I think, in terms of you don't have to go to the hardware button, but not a huge deal. All right, so we'll take a look now at the video player on each phone. On the iPod, you access it via hitting the iPod. On the iPhone, you hit it in the, accessing the iPod button on the front. And on the Pre, in the launcher, there's a videos app. And as you'll see, I've loaded the same video file on both phones. The Have Fun phone, or Have Fun video rather, is something that was preloaded on the Palm. It's a tour. But I've got an episode of 30 Rock from my computer. You can see it's the same one, episode 19, 20 minutes, 41 seconds long. The Pre tells you the file size, a little extra information there. So I'm gonna play it back on both devices just so you can see the exact same file running on each phone. Now this file was not specifically compressed and formatted for either of these devices. It's actually a raw HDTV file. But since I had it, I figured I'd load it up and see what happens. So both phones default to widescreen. Whoops. Let's get it back actually to the very beginning. So you can see both phones have controls overlaid on the front of the screen. And I'll tip these up a little so you can see the playback a little better. Controls overlaid in the front of the screen. Basically the same thing. You've got a scrubber that'll let you, you know, go through the movie. The new iPhone 3S, the scrubber, a little tiny bit different, but, you know, basically the same thing. You can go all the way back to the beginning. I guess on the pre, you don't have the skip to the forward and beginning and end buttons, small detail. And then you've got the, you know, the stretch to fit, so you can go from letterbox mode to full screen stretch to fit. So let's hit play on both of these. Kind of a weird stereo effect going on with the sound coming out of both devices just slightly off sync there, so let's turn that off. And so you can see, you know, the quality pretty good on both. Again, the pre, a little bit brighter, as I showed in the video where I was talking about the web browser. The pre-screen just a little tiny bit brighter in my eyes. Same resolution, the iPod gives you, the iPhone gives you a physically slightly larger screen, 3.5 inches versus 3.1. But they're basically, you know, basically the same. They both look good, pretty much stutter-free. The audio's on sync, and there you go. She's very spirited like a show horse. That's such a great show, 30 Rock. So then obviously the big difference that you're going to get with the iPhone that you're not going to get with the pre is the whole ecosystem of iTunes, where you can go into the iTunes store and you can purchase and download video content. Apparently you're going to be able to rent video content soon as well. So, you know, you can hit the videos button. And you've got movies, TV shows, and music videos. Get into it in this video, but it definitely is something if you're interested in the mobile TV, and it comes with the service, so, you know. So here's the YouTube app, and basically on the pre here, it's kind of bare bones. You've got, you can go popular, most viewed, or your own viewing history. On the iPhone, a little bit more robust, and the new OS 3 version allows you to sign into your account to access your own stuff, so you can go to My Videos and subscriptions and that kind of thing. All right, and so once you're looking at videos in the YouTube apps, you can see the iPhone app offers a few more things. You can go today, this week, or all, featured, most viewed. You can do your favorites and stuff, and then, you know, top rated, most recent, your own, and then your own personal information based on your, you know, if you're signed in. So if I'm signed in here, I should be able to get to the Phone Dog videos. Yep. So there you go. Look at all those Phone Dog videos. Go watch them. Go watch all of them. There's even more of them. There's so many. Whereas on the pre, again, this is just a version one of the app. And, you know, most likely you'll see more stuff coming out in future versions in terms of features and that kind of thing. But, you know, you can watch your videos. So we'll search. Let's see if we can get the same video up on both of these. We'll go to Seth Meyers' opening monologue. I like Seth Meyers. Seth Meyers. Yep, all right, so we've got the same video. Seth Meyers' opening monologue at the Webby Awards. So we'll hit it on both phones. And again, widescreen mode by default.
Second time hosting, so I can tell you from experience that if you love the Oscars, but you always wish there were fewer celebrities and more awards, tonight is the night for you.
And so there you go. Pretty similar. Again, the pre seems to be a little bit brighter, maybe even a little bit sharper.
Nothing says ingenuity and forward thinking and the future.
And in the pre, you can minimize it. Although the playback stopped. And so there you go. Anyway, so the actual app, the YouTube app for iPhone, you know, it's version 3 of the OS, so it's been around a little bit longer, a little more advanced. The pre-YouTube app obviously works for watching videos, which is, you know, the crux of what you want. And, you know, I wouldn't think that, even though the YouTube app for iPhone is a little bit better, I wouldn't think that the pre-YouTube app is going to be a deal breaker for anybody who's interested in this phone, but it's just like, oh man, you know, the YouTube app's not advanced. Because you can always go to the website and log into the YouTube website if you want to get your own personal features. So there you go, quick look at the audio and video players on the Palm Pre and the iPhone. I think as a pure multimedia machine, the iPhone's got the edge just because it's been around a little bit longer, and so the actual apps are a little bit more robust in terms of the advanced playback features, the iPod, you know, the EQ on the iPod, if you like that kind of thing, to customize your music, although a lot of audiophiles just want their music flat, but you can compensate for small speakers or, you know, bad headphones or whatever. And then the other features, obviously, with the YouTube app, like we showed, and then all of the iTunes store stuff, a little more advanced, more choices, more features than the Amazon MP3 store. That being said, if you're kind of more of a do-it-yourself person, or if you want the Sprint TV, the Pre certainly gets the job done in terms of playing back music and video files, and then Sprint TV, you know, is a bonus in some people's eyes. And the Amazon MP3 store, oftentimes you'll be able to get deals on music a little bit cheaper than some of the stuff in the iTunes store. It all just depends what you're looking to buy and on what day. So there you go. There's a look at the audio and video players, the YouTube functionality on both devices.